Our blue planet having water seems such a basic and obvious fact that the question of why Earth has water at all seems unimportant. However, the origin of this vital component of life has long been a source of contention. For a while, it's believed that Earth's water did not originate from the planet's region of the protoplanetary disk. Instead, it was hypothesized water and other volatiles must have been delivered to Earth from the outer solar system later in its history. According to models of solar system formation, Earth, being an inner solar system planet, should contain little or no water. Early models of planetary formation predicted that the nebular gas near our young sun was too hot to form ice. As a result, water as vapor could not have easily been incorporated into the materials that form the inner rocky planets Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars. Only the outer solar system planets, such as Jupiter, have an abundance of water and other volatiles because they developed outside the snow line, the hypothetical boundary between water vapor and water ice in the solar nebula. These planets formed far enough away from the sun to be able to incorporate frozen water easily. Earth not only contains water in its oceans and atmosphere, but it also has the equivalent of multiple oceans of water trapped within its deep inner rocks. Scientists can study special kinds of meteorites formed at the beginning of the solar system to help solve this puzzle. These space rocks, known as chondrites, have not been chemically modified and incorporated into a giant planet. The isotopic makeup of Earth shows that instatite chondrite-like materials are the primary building blocks of rocky planets. Nonetheless, instatite chondrites were thought to be too dry to account for Earth's water. Instead, carbonaceous chondrite, a water-rich kind of chondrite, was believed to have brought most of the planet's water. On the other hand, carbonaceous chondrites are not ideal because they formed outside of the snow line and have a considerably different isotopic composition than Earth. To explain these seeming contradictions, carbonaceous chondrite-like material is claimed to have been brought to Earth from beyond the snow line when the planet was already mostly formed. The birth of Jupiter, or the inner solar system wandering, is assumed to have disrupted the orbits of asteroids, ejecting them from the outer section of the asteroid belt, causing these chondrites to pummel the early Earth. In addition, the composition of the water and meteorites doesn't precisely match that of Earth's. The extraterrestrial version contains more deuterium, a heavier form of hydrogen, indicating that there must have been another source of the water on our planet. Recently, an international team tried to unravel the missing source of Earth's water, the sun. Curtin University researchers have contributed to the long-standing mystery of the origin of the Earth's water, revealing the sun as a surprising potential source. According to a team of international researchers led by the University of Glasgow, including researchers from Curtin Space Science and Technology Center, SSTC, the solar wind played a role in forming water. The solar wind, which is made up of charged particles from the sun that are mostly hydrogen ions, created water on the surface of dust grains carried on asteroids that smashed into the Earth during the solar system's early days. The Earth has a lot of water compared to other rocky planets in the solar system, with oceans covering more than 70% of its surface. And scientists have been trying to figure out where it all comes from for a long time. This new solar wind theory is based on an atom-by-atom examination of tiny shards of the Itokawa asteroid, an S-type near-Earth asteroid retrieved by the Japanese space probe Hayabusa and returned to Earth in 2010. The scientists used Curtin University's world-class atom probe tomography system to get an incredibly detailed look inside the first 50 nanometers or so of the surface of Itokawa dust grains, which they discovered contained enough water to amount to about 20 liters per cubic meter of rock if scaled up. Dr. Luke Daly, a Curtin graduate who now works at the University of Glasgow, said the findings not only provide scientists with a unique insight into the ancient source of Earth's water, but it could also aid future space missions. One of the challenges of future space exploration is how astronauts would get enough water without carrying supplies. The same space weathering process that formed water on Itokawa most certainly occurred on other airless planets, implying that astronauts may be able to process fresh supplies of water directly from the dust on a planet's surface, such as the moon. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.